Hi everyone, in this video we will see some MCQ on fields and vectors and find the solution also. First question is identify the vector field. Four options are given. In that we have to find what are the vector fields. See, vector field, whenever we talk about field, field is talking about particular point. Right, so vector field means vector representing a particular point. So we have to take care of point. So out of these four options, if you see A and C, they are a function. They are a function of x, y, z. This vector is having a variable x, y, z. Whereas if you take B and D, it is talking about phi I minus 3j, that is one point, phi comma minus 3 is one point. Like that 2i plus 3j indicates 2 comma 3. So out of these four, B and D are talking about point or field. So B and D are fields, whereas A and C are vector function. It is having a variable x, y, z, so they are coming under the category of function. But if you substitute x is equal to 1 or y is equal to 2 and z is equal to 3, they will become a point. Let us assume x, y, z is equal to 1. So what this a will become, x, y is 1, so it is 2i plus x, z both are 1, so it is 7j. So it is 2i plus 7j, then it will become a points. Right, so field is bothering about particular point, whereas vector function is a function of some variable. So here the answer is both B and D. So option 2 is correct. So option 2. Next we go to problem number 2, identify the vector function. So as I explained in problem number 1, you see question option B and D are talking about particular point, so they are not coming under the category of field, whereas A and C are vector function, because A is having some x and y, C is having some x, y, z. So we can substitute some value for x, y, z. X, y, z is a point. So once we substitute point, then only they will become function. So answer for field. So answer is A and C, whereas B and D are vector field. And next question, modulus of del t is equal to 0 at a point t x, y, z implies that dt and d are dash. Says, what is modulus of del t? It is a magnitude of gradient. So del t is gradient, modulus indicates magnitude. So magnitude of gradient is 0 at point. When magnitude of gradient is 0 at some particular point, so we know that the gradient is talking about maximum change. So when that maximum change will be 0, if there is no change, then we can say it is its value is 0. So I should say that it should be a stationary point. So my scalar should be a stationary, then only we can say the maximum change is 0. So it should be a stationary point, and they are talking about dt and t. So here we are going to find, for example, del t is, let us take t is a t. So del t is the gradient of t. So at that point, t should not change, because gradient is talking about maximum change. They ask, my gradient is 0. So when gradient will be 0? If that point is a stationary point. For stationary point, there is no change. So t must be a stationary point, and the rate of change must be 0. So dt is rate of change of t. T is a particular point. So dt must be 0 and t must be stationary. So option B is correct. Right. Next one, del acting on a vector produces another vector is known as dash. Already we know that. If you are having any doubt, see the video on curl. If del acts on a vector and it produces another vector, then it is known as curl operation. So option B is correct. Next one, del acting on a scalar produces another scalar, right? So del acting on a scalar, we are having two operations. Del acting on a scalar results in vector means that is a gradient. Del acting on a scalar which results in another scalar is Laplacian, right? So if you are having any doubt, see the vector introduction video that I have put in some other area. And sixth one, del acting on a vector produces another scalar. So del acting on a vector produces another scalar is nothing but divergence. Right, so if you are having any doubt, see divergence video. Next, closed integral del t dot dl, right? Del t is a vector, dl is also a vector. Closed integral del t dot dl, we know that integral del t dot dl is equal to t of b minus t of A if integration goes from A to B. If you are having any doubt, refer our gradient video. So here what they ask is closed integral of del t dl. Closed means starting and end points are same. That means both A is equal to starting and end means, here we know that B is a end point, A is a starting point. Closed means A is equal to B. If you substitute A is equal to B in this equation, what we get is T of A minus T of A or T of B minus T of B. So the answer becomes 0. So what is the correct answer? The answer is A. So the option is. So next question, del acting on a scalar produces another vector is. Already I told, if del acting on a scalar produces another vector means that is a gradient. If you are having any doubt, you can go and refer gradient video. Okay. Next one, measurement of a rotation of vector is given by, rotation means curl, right? So already we know that. So measurement of rotation of vector is known as curl. It is a well-known direct question. Del t at any point is dashed to the constant t that passes through that point. Del t is nothing but your gradient t. If we take t is a temperature, it is a temperature gradient. So temperature gradient at any point is dashed to the constant t, right? So constant t means it is not changing at particular point, it is fixed. And del t is talking about maximum rate of change. So the answer is contradicting. So it must be 0. Then only for a constant t, del t becomes 0. So the answer is 0.